first started skating, what drew me in was all the kids.
I just can't keep doing this. There are these amazing skaters who just skate for no reason, when I have the biggest reason of all to be an amazing skater. My father, your cousin, Throckmorton, is the best skater in the entire world. Then there are these people who are just out here skating for whatever reason.
I just don't know what I'm gonna do about this. It's so frustrating that I can't be the best skater in the world when I have the biggest reason. I mean, look at these skaters like Tony Hawk. Just out here skating what? For the fun of it? That's no reason at all. When I have my father, your cousin Throckmorton. I can't believe I just can't get motivated and be the greatest skater that I'm meant to be. What's holding me back?
Everything around me reminds me of how I have to become a good skater. One even better than my father, Throckmorton. Everything just keeps telling me to speed up. What even is living if I can't skate? If I can't skate, then I'm nothing more than scum. A poser. Which is even worse than scum. If the gods gave me this amazing ability to skate, how can I not take it? They have given me the perfect situation. I am the child of Throckmorton, the coolest skater to ever exist. That's a fact. How can I not skate when there are so many others who skate just because they want to? I need to stop being so lame by overthinking and overanalyzing. Only lame people overthink and overanalyze about skating.
I have the motivation and the it factor to be the best skater out there.
It's as obvious as the ground under my super rad kicks that I have to do this. Look at my father, your cousin Throckmorton. He has been skating fearlessly for years, earned no money or credit from it. I applaud him. To be truly great, you don't need the money or the fame. You just need to be like my father, your cousin Throckmorton, who skates with no motive. It means even if there's no reason to skate, you do it anyways, just for the gosh darn heck of it. So where does that leave me, the unmotivated son of Throckmorton? I've been thrown from the super cool and totally not toxic skating community. Lost the support of my father and the motivation to even skate again. No, I cannot be this way when there are tons of people out there with no purpose besides skating. I must skate because my potential will be wasted. I'll do it. I'll skate.
Hey, thank you for watching. This is just kind of my explanation of the whole video. Starting off, this idea originated from a meme a couple years ago, the My Cousin Throckmorton meme. I wanted to still encase the idea of motivation, or lack thereof motivation, while keeping the darker points more subdued, just kind of bringing a more comical sense to it all, less death and revenge, and more focused on the motivation aspect of it. I wanted to portray Hamlet as kind of a younger individual. Even though he's confirmed to be 30, I still very much see him as an indecisive, hasn't matured very much kind of person, and by the end of the play we see through his soliloquies that he's come to an acceptance, and that's kind of showing his maturity. I also want to portray it as him living in like a shadow of greatness, because Hamlet constantly feels like there's something more that he has to live up to. And although he isn't living in the shadow of his father like this character, he's definitely living in kind of a shadow of greatness, because he references a lot of Greek mythology, a lot of Greek mythological heroes. In this delivery of the version of this soliloquy, I wanted to kind of start with a base of motivation already, rather than in the original one, where it's kind of a slow, gradual buildup and you kind of feel the awe he has for Fortinbras. But with this one, the motivation's already there. There's not a lot of buildup. It's just kind of building on that base of motivation that's already there.